Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Mandy. If you are new here, welcome. Today I'm bringing you lots of cleaning motivation. We are going to be working in Isabella's room and putting together a couple pieces of furniture. And I want to thank Yitahome for sending Isabella a bookshelf, but this bookshelf is not like your regular bookshelf. So definitely watch all the way through so that you don't miss this cool, amazing bookshelf. I will have the links for the bookshelf down in the description. So let's get started. I'm going to first start by dusting off Isabella's ceiling fan. It gets so much dust on it because she uses it all the time, all during the night and during the day when she's at home. It's amazing how much dust gets built up on this thing. Now, Isabella does clean her own room. She dusts the furniture and vacuums and does all that. She even does her own laundry, but I will not allow her to get up on a ladder to dust the ceiling fan. I know it had been a while since I dusted it myself, so I needed to get that done first. While I was doing that, Isabella was taking the sheets off of her bed. She was gonna go wash those, and she left a pillowcase behind. But she, like I said, she washes her own laundry and does a really good job at it. She's been doing that since she was about 7 years old. Whenever we bought our front load washing machine, I taught her how to do it. And when she was first starting, I would buy the little Tide Pods or Gain Flings, whatever they're called, just to make it easier on her to put the soap or the detergent into the washer. But she has done an amazing job at it. She folds her laundry, puts it away, and does really good. So there was quite a few little dust bunnies under the dresser that I just took out of the bedroom. So I'm gonna vacuum all of the floor back here, vacuum off the baseboards, and then I'll mop this little area using my O-Cedar mop. And then we start in on putting this cool bookshelf together. This bookshelf is like a tree stand bookshelf. It was pretty easy to put together. One time I put on the wrong board and that was just completely by mistake. Each board is actually labeled with little stickers, letters on the boards, and even the bags that the screws and everything comes in is labeled for which letter it is. So it's very easy to follow the directions. I just kind of skipped a page and messed up on one of the pieces, but it was an easy fix. I just had to take it apart on that one board and redo it. But it was very fun putting this together with Isabella. We enjoyed doing this together and just getting to spend some time together. So the bookshelf is all put together, but we're not going to style it just yet with the books because I needed to go ahead and rearrange the furniture and get everything cleaned up. So now I'm just vacuuming off Isabella's headboard. It was pretty dusty on the top. I don't think she actually has dusted that off. She's probably just forgotten about that. And I'm just gonna move the bed over. I really like the bed on this wall much better than the other one, but a few weeks ago, or actually probably a couple months ago, Isabella cleaned her room and decided she wanted to move the furniture. So she did that all on her own. So now I'm just gonna vacuum where the bed was and get that little area mopped, and then I will start in on other things and Isabella will start putting her books on her bookshelf. And if you're wondering why the headboard is not actually attached to the bed, the rails that the mattress is on, the bed rails, does not line up with the holes on the headboard. I need to, I guess, have Jason cut a piece of wood or something and make it to where we could put it together. But actually, I think it makes it a little bit easier for whenever we do move the furniture. You're not trying to move this whole big bed with the headboard and everything. So I don't know, maybe we'll just leave it the way it is. As long as the bed stays in front of the headboard, it works. It's just fine. One step forward and another back. I would never try to fool ya. I'm one heartbeat away from going mad. Girl, when you look like that, So if you are new to my channel, welcome. Like I said earlier, my name is Mandy. I am a full-time working outside of the home mom. I have three daughters, one of which has already left the nest. And if you're wondering why my vacuuming and mopping is kind of choppy, I'm not vacuuming the whole floor all at one time. Whenever I rearrange furniture, I always move a piece of furniture, vacuum, mop it under where that piece of furniture used to be, and then I will put a new piece of furniture in that spot and then go back to where that was and vacuum and mop it. So yes, it is very choppy whenever I rearrange furniture. When I come into a room and I'm just cleaning, I'm not moving furniture around, I do vacuum the floors all at one time and then go back and mop the floors all at one time. So now I'm just tying up the curtains into a knot so that they're not hanging down in the floor and getting in the way when I'm trying to vacuum and mop this little area. A while ago, we had put this little cube shelf in her closet just so she could put her books and things in there, but it was really just too wide for her closet. It was hard for her to get her laundry hamper out and everything. So we're going to be taking that out, and I'm just going to vacuum that area of the closet and give it a good mop. And I'm going to bring in the chest of drawers that used to be in our master bedroom. If you haven't seen where I redid our master bedroom, I'll link it at the top and I'll add that in the description below. So we just put that chest in there, and I wasn't sure what I was going to do with the shelf here, but I thought, well, she could always use a little extra storage for her extra things that she has. So I went ahead and just left that in her room. I do need to get new cubbies, the little baskets or whatever you call them, just some new ones. Those are really worn out, and a couple of them are actually broken, and I need to get some that actually match her room, or that's a little more neutral. That way if I move it out into the living room or wherever else I could move it to, it'll kind of be neutral and match the decor. are all finished drying, so I'm just putting those back on the bed. And she does not sleep with the flat sheet. I don't understand why, but she doesn't like the flat sheet, but she loves sleeping with her wolf blanket. I love this blanket. It's so soft and cuddly. Her grandparents bought this for her for Christmas one year. Bella loves wolves, and so that is what she sleeps with. You gotta listen up, there's not a thing that I can't get from you. Boy, I don't need that much, how can I tell you what I wanna do? I never needed you to give me things, I never needed gifts or diamond rings, all I We're all finished with her room. We put together the bookshelf and her new desk that she bought. She wanted to save up her money and buy it herself, so there it is. She's very proud of that desk. And as you can see out the blinds, it is now getting dark. This project took a little longer than I had expected it to take. But here's the new bookshelf, all styled with her books. We love this bookshelf. So thank you so much, Yitahome, for sending this to us. Isabella absolutely loves it, and just being able to see all of her books, it just brings so much color into her room, and we just love it. Don't forget to check out the links below if you have a book lover in your life and they could use another bookshelf in their home. Check out the links below. This would be a wonderful gift. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.